So today I'm going to spill with you a few of my favorite beauty secrets, but it's not what you expect. It's actually things that you can use from your pantry, from your fridge, that you would have used as groceries otherwise, to really enhance your beauty routine. So we all know that to have a perfect base for your makeup, it takes more than just creams. It takes more than just piling on the makeup. It starts with your skin and how you take care of your body. So I'm going to show you a couple of my favorite tricks and tips, and I actually pretty much completely rely on these items for face masks, for scrubs, makeup remover, and they're all natural. I really like keeping everything, as far as skincare goes, very, very natural in my body. I have sensitive skin, so I do react if things are a bit too abrasive or if there's too many chemicals in there. So I really like this route, and it doesn't cost you anything extra. You're not spending all of your money on different beauty products. So olive oil is my first. I think I use this the most. I use this in my bath for bath oil. I also use it as makeup remover. How I use it is I put the olive oil all over my face. It takes off everything, even lipstick, even waterproof eyeliner, even waterproof mascara, everything. All of your foundation, everything. And I pair it with, I just use a sea mud soap. So that I have to buy. I can't make that, and I definitely don't want to eat that. So I'm not going to find that at the grocery store. But for the actual taking off the makeup, it's the olive oil that does the trick. You can really pair it with any soap that you have, or if you have a special skin soap, if your skin is very oily. And that's another thing. Just because it's olive oil and you're putting olive oil or any kind of oil really on your skin doesn't mean that you're going to break out. Some things are actually very good for the pH balance of your skin, and it's not going to affect it. It's not going to make you break out more, nothing like that. It's really going to hydrate your skin in a lot of ways. I mean, after I use that as my makeup remover, I don't usually put any moisturizer on because the olive oil does that too. It kind of multitasks. Next, I would say this is sugar and salt for my scrubs. You want to make sure that's granulated sugar. I have tried with finer salt. I've tried with even the brown sugar, and it's not the same effect. I mean, if that's all you have, use it and it will work. But the best one to get is the granulated sugar. And you can add that. I mean, you can use that as a scrub all over your body. It's really nice. It's very coarse. So it really, I don't know, for exfoliating, gets all of your dead skin cells off, and it's still very, very gentle because at a certain point it just dissolves. So it's not like it's an almond shell or anything like that and it's going to keep scratching at your skin. It's just going to dissolve when it's done. So you can't really overdo it. That's good because you don't want to get your skin aggravated and too dry. So I use that on my face, on my body for exfoliation. Some of the time too, I'll pair it with honey. So I'll do a scrub on my face and then I'll put honey over as a mask. And what honey does is, first of all, it's a great hydrator, but also it's kind of like a natural disinfectant. So if you do have, I guess, a little bit more acne-prone skin, it's good because you just leave it on. The best one to use is organic honey. And it actually, when you leave it on for long enough, it creates little bubbles and it actually gives oxygen to your skin. And anyways, I find that this is really good, you know, especially if I feel like my skin's going to be breaking out or anything. I always put honey everywhere, and it tastes good if you get some in your mouth, so it's good. Yogurt does the same thing. Obviously the best one is the thicker Mediterranean yogurt. You can use this as a mask, and you can use it all over, you know, body mask. It's very, very hydrating. Usually I'll use this more in the winter when my skin is more dry and it needs a little bit extra, you know, a little bit of TLC. Avocado is really great too. You can use this as a mask, as a body mask, and this is especially good for your hair. Avocado is really full of omega-3 fats, so it's naturally very, very creamy and oily. And when you mash it up, and you can even, you know, you can add some olive oil in there too. A little bit of honey will help too. And you can just make these masks, you know, for pretty much your whole body. But it's really, really good for your hair. And last but not least is milk. I'm sure you've all heard of how Cleopatra used to bathe in milk. Obviously, you don't want to fill up your whole bathtub with milk because that could get messy and pretty cold. But just adding a little bit to your bath water will actually soften the water, and it will, you'll see when you get out, your skin will be a lot softer. So use these all together and mix and match them, but I'm sure, like, there's, it's impossible for you to not like at least one of them. They're all great, and I find them usually more effective than the stuff that you can buy in the drugstore. So enjoy.